Yo guys, this is Drunk Animation, aka Wookie. Join the Drunk Animation Guild and the Discord. The link's down in the description down below. Right there. You see that? See that button right there? Click it. Join them and click the link. And also, if you want to watch more of me, the amazing Drunk Animation, my Twitch channel is also down below. And it's also in the description down below. Right there. I told you. Right there. Down there.
Pardon me, sir, but about those curious demigod statues I've seen.
What? Who are you? Why do you ask?
They're quite clever.
Oh, thank you. A lot of craftsmanship and care went into them. I assume.
So you did create them?
Yes, I did. It was a ploy to give that pathetic oaf Moon a taste of the grief he caused me years ago. You are the one who's been pilfering them.
I am, at the request of Mr. Moon. I received your owl on your stationery.
Ah, well, fitting Moon would enlist a student. Too cowardly to do it himself. Hasn't changed a bit. Even when we were at school, he was a cowardly bully. Gave me a horrible nickname, which I shan't repeat. I was thrilled when we left school and he seemed gone for good. Then I started seeing him around Hogsmeade. It was too much. Even if I do take satisfaction in that his life's destiny was to be a lowly caretaker.
He is a bit much for a caretaker, but he means well, and he's terrified of those statues.
I know. You should have seen his face when that boggart appeared. Oh, priceless. That's when I knew what I needed to do. I simply didn't want to encounter him anymore. So, I shrewdly put a boggart in his path to learn his greatest fear. I then created the demiguy statues to keep him in his place, so to speak. The Moons were inspired to play on his name. It worked brilliantly. Until you started clearing them out.
The statues are a form of bullying. You're no better than him. Perhaps it's time you both moved on.
Fair point, I suppose. If they've terrified him, as you say, he may have learned his lesson.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased.
Mr. Moon, I've learned who's behind the demigod statues. It was an old schoolmate of yours, Piers Pemberton.
Oh, my unknown! Pigtails Piers!
I don't think he likes being called that.
Of course he does! Oh, he had such flowing locks, and we used to laugh about them! I laughed the hardest of all! Clever, clever man. I'd no idea he was so devious! capitulate him. Whatever statues remain seem less terrifying now that I know they were put out by old pigtails. Continue collecting them if you like. As for me, I'm gonna go and pay a visit to my old friend.
Adelaide Oaks, isn't it? I received your owl.
Yes, I'm Adelaide Oaks. Oh dear. You see, my uncle Rowland is a metal trader who's quite well known in the goblin community. He normally sends me owls every week when he's on his business travels. In his last owl, he alluded to dealings with those radical goblins, Ranrock's loyalists. It's been ages since that owl and I'm worried. What with the troll attack on Hogsmeade and the rumors that goblins may have been involved, well, I'm fearing the worst. Should I be worried about my uncle, or am I overthinking this?
I think you're right to be concerned, Adelaide. Your uncle may be in trouble.
You're much more understanding than Professor Weasley. She heard I was going to look for him and forbade me from leaving the grounds. She's convinced he can handle himself, but I can't concentrate on anything until I know he's all right. Could you try to find out for me? From what I hear, you're almost as adventurous as Uncle Rowland.
Has your uncle traded with many goblins?
Yes, for ages. Even speaks gobbledygook. But he only recently mentioned Ranrock's lot. Insisting the galleons were worth the risk. He does it for me. Between robes and supplies, attending Hogwarts costs a fair sickle. And besides that, Uncle Rowland has expensive taste. He's sacrificed so much for me over the years. I promised him that as soon as I finish Hogwarts, I shall be the one taking care of him.
I'll try and look into it for you, Adelaide.
Thank you. He's very thorough in his record keeping. Notes all his trades in a journal, makes maps. In fact, in his last owl, he drew me a map of his next stop. He'd planned to set up camp north of here. I do hope you're able to find out where he is. Thank you again for any help you can provide.
I hope Adelaide's Uncle Rowland is all right. She seems very worried. Adelaide mentioned her uncle's camp may be near Brockborough, past the river. This be Mr. Oaks' campsite? Ranrock's loyalists, just ahead. Should I take them by force or be discreet? Horcrux's trade journal.
Wingardium Leviosa. Arresto Lament Accio. Descendo.
Looks intriguing.
Revelio.
Adelaide said that her uncle kept notes of his trades, maps. Perhaps these landmarks will lead me to him. Mr. Oakes's trade journal. A rock formation. That's the first landmark on this map. Now to find the crooked tree.
That curiosity young people tend to nurture never ends well for them, does it?
Who lived here, I wonder? Crooked tree, just as the map said. The crumbling tower shouldn't be far from here. And the crumbling tower. The spot on the map should be directly south of here. What do we have here? Wingardium Leviosa. I may have more luck higher up in the keep.
Revelio.
I don't like the looks of that encampment. Revelio.
As a grapple, you are.
Petrificus Totalus.
You haven't had mushroom stew like what my mother used to make. Oh, like heads of lettuce, those mushrooms were.
Revelio. This castle's hiding all sorts of secrets. A ladder. That's what I need.
Used for better things than this so-called patrol.
Petrificus Totalus.
Who's the... Such arrogance.
Of course.
Descender. Repender.
I hate that!
Confringo. Repender. Incendio. Capulso. Flupendo.
Is somebody there? Hello?
Most goblins in my family worked in the mines at one time or other. Big meal, you'll be slowed down, babe. Light, and you'll be swift.
This is the spot on the map. I'd best have my wits about me.
Confringo!
Almost!
Rependo!
Stone walls do a prison make, sometimes. What will we find in here?
Hello, Homura.
Someone's here.
Confringo!
Your blood's on Ranrock's hands.
Revelio.
Revelio.
It looks as though Adelaide's instincts were spot on.
Next time I see Fig or that student, I'll give them what they deserve.
Confirm. To open it.
One way or another, we'll get what we're owed.
Come back on pudding. Mistook you for a troll the other day.
Spell it off.
I won't rest until you're
Revelio.
I wonder if Adelaide's uncle could be down there.
Confirm! Yeah.
I won't rest!
Expelliarmus!
You're dead! Rebellion.
Hello? Mr. Oakes?
Yes, I'm here. They've taken my wand. This cell has an enchanted lock. I have experience with these locks, but I need my wand if I have any chance of opening it. Look for a boiler door. I've heard them speak of it.
I need to find Mr. Oakes's wand. Where could it be?
Revelio.
This must be Mr. Oakes's wand. Perhaps now he can set himself free.
Arrest them, Lorenzo. Incendio.
You did it! Oh, I found my wand and... Wait, you're a student? Oh, we must get you to safety immediately. It's dangerous.
It's all right, Mr. Oaks. I've dealt with these goblins before.
Dear Merlin, you're either very lucky or very talented. How did you find me?
I'm a friend of Adelaide's. She was worried about your business with Ranrock's loyalists.
Oh, she was right to be. I couldn't go through with the agreement, and when I told them, I ended up blindfolded and behind bars. Been locked in that infernal cell for so long, they'd forgot I was even there. I overheard things. If only I could reward you for what you've done. Blasted goblins stole every canut on me. All I can say is thank you, truly.
You mentioned you overheard things.
Sad tale, really. I think I know where Ranrock's unfortunate vendetta against wizardkind began. Although dragon breeding was outlawed by the Warlocks' Convention of 1709, Ranrock stumbled upon an illegal dragon camp. He was young, found the creatures fascinating. He'd visit the camp in secret whenever he could, never making his presence known. After weeks of sly surveillance, he finally summoned the courage to speak to the wizard in charge. Ranrock wanted to join them and the creatures. The wizard happened to drop his wand. Ranrock saw an opportunity. He picked it up, went to hand it back as a means of introducing himself. The sight of a goblin with a wand sent the wizard into an instant rage. He beat Ranrock nearly to death. Ever since, Ranrock has despised wizardkind, sees us all as cruel.
I'm grateful I was able to help you, Mr. Oaks. Adelaide thinks the world of you.
Oh, and I her. She's become quite savvy to my trading habits, always analyzing my detailed owls. Oh, if only I hadn't resorted to trading with such fiends. A lesson I shan't soon forget. Having my wand back is like being reunited with an old friend. I must return home and inform Adelaide of my safety. Will you be all right?
I'll be fine, Mr. Oaks. You get back to Adelaide. I assure you. Her worries outweigh yours.
Oh, I'm anxious to see my dear niece. And then I plan to travel far from here for my next round of trading. Thank you. May life reward you justly for your deeds. Be well, my friend.
Mr. Oaks was lucky. Ranrock's lot would never have freed him.
Revelio.
One less human to worry about.
Confirm. Defend them. Place it. Perfectus Totalus. You only have Ranrock to blame.
You won't
Remember to watch anime and read manga.